Hello Rudy, this is Srikant. So today I'm going to talk about the Next.js 13 Google AdSense ad unit code. About my last video, as I said, I will be explaining it. I'm very late. Okay, normally Google gives us a code in three parts, like script component, which is also used for auto ads also, then INS, and then the script code. It only changes it to INS script. Okay. So what will happen is that we are just gonna need this part to add into our head like this, but we do not. Okay. But we can just add that in Next.js. There is a script component for this. Okay. We are just gonna use the script component of the Next.js, and here and here. And okay, so our code is done. We will need to make it a lazy load, strategy lazy and load, but I'm just gonna change. So this will run your auto ad. This is also used for the single ad unit code. Normally, the remaining part. Normally, what happens is that we can try this type, this part of ad unit code, and just paste it in any page, anywhere in a page. But this will not work because this part of code had to be run. And it's not gonna run because we have to use script component at here. But even if we use script component, it will load only once because it's by default, Next.js optimizes that script component on a one page, and it should be not loaded again and again. Like if we try to change our page, the ad unit code will not refresh. See? Like this. So for that issue, there was a package named Next Google AdSense, but it will not gonna also work because if you are using the app router, the Next.js says new use router, app router, then this type of packages, any packages that are made before the Next.js 13 cannot be used at here because Next.js itself changes some documentation about use router hook up there. Like they removed some functionality from the use router. They also have to be imported from the next/navigation instead of next/router. Wait a minute. See, in pages router, there is next router. It is imported from next route, and it has some functions like router.events. Like it can track easily that page has been changed or not in pages router of Next.js, but it will not gonna happen in our app router. So for that case, see, there was a package like this, and just wait a minute. See, clearly see, there is a router object. If you go under the GitHub repo of any Next.js Google AdSense package, anyone, and just go into the code. No, this is not the part. Wait a minute. Yes, response ad unit code. See, they are importing use router from the next/router, not the next/navigation. So this code will work fine without any issue, without any problem in the pages router, but it will not work on the app router of Next.js 13 and above. For that, we will need some changes to our code. So part one out of three part one is completed. just strategy is gonna be lazy on load, not after interactive. I tried every strategy, but the lazy on load is only the one which was working for me. Okay. Part. Okay. So we are gonna create some components. Let me generally. Okay. We are gonna create a specific component for our ad units. There will be gonna two files. First, we will gonna create Google Ad Unit Client dot PSX. You can use JSX if you are using TypeScript. I'm using TypeScript, but there is not much of changes in code. You can understand. Don't worry. So I'm gonna yes. Okay. I'm gonna make it use client. Okay, this is a client component. We are gonna create two files. This one is a client component. It gonna have parameters of children, which will be obviously a React node. If you are not using the TypeScript, you can still use it, just you don't have to specify the types. Okay, so we will gonna need some changes right here. Yes, fragment, which is imported from React, and at here we will gonna add children. Okay, nothing is happening. Take another problem. So we also got the third script part, three part of our program. We are just gonna need use effect at here. Wait a minute. Okay. Use instead of router in Next.js 13 and above the app router, instead of use router, they suggested some other packages other hooks. Use path name and use search params for tracking the page change. See, I'm just gonna copy them. It's imported from the next navigation. Okay, see, I'm also gonna copy this. I'm just not gonna waste the time to type. Okay, they are added. Then the third, the script part, which should be run on every page load on for every component. I'm just gonna create. Wait a minute. I will need an interface. No problem. I'll just go with use effect. And the code that should be done. See, it's React, so we have to change this part to window dot errors by Google. So in TypeScript, it will gonna have show this error of errors by Google is not identified. I'm just gonna add this part there. Okay, dependencies are added. So our code will run every time our path changes. Every time our path changes, it will refresh our code in there. And it should be window.adds by Google, not the adds by Google equal to vagera vagera. I'm just gonna change the TypeScript error. Global interface window. I think this should make it work. Any array. Why is not working? Wait a minute. I think I have some syntax issue about the interfaces for the global interface. That's it. Okay. Showing some Java, of course. Instead of Java, we need JavaScript. I mean TypeScript. Okay. Thank you, buddy. From Stack Overflow, help there. Global, declare global interface window with a capital W and ads by Google. Copy. Wait. Okay. And any array. They may be changing something else, but we are just gonna any array. So we will need another component, which will be a server component. Google add unit dot tsx. See? Okay. So I'm just gonna create a server component at here. I'm using Python, so instead of double slash, I use the hash value. Okay. Now why would we need a server component also? I'm just gonna show you. We will make it in the suspense. Okay, our add unit code. Oh, okay. It asks for the children. So we are just gonna add the similar children, and type of children will be children React node. React node. Okay. Add unit client, and I'm just gonna pass the same children to the client component. It should be in curly brackets. Okay, so our server component is ready. So why did I create the server component? Because I wanna make that component should be run only in a production environment, not the development environment. In short, the AdSense script should run only in the production environment, in a website part, not the development, because it creates some issues about in writing the program. Just wait a minute. I think I found it. Okay, no problem. So this is our client component. I'm just gonna add a new parameter here, is production, which will be a boolean like true or false, and this code will run only in the production. Is production also added the into dependency tree? I don't have to change something. So in a development environment, it just gonna console log the currently running in or currently in development. Okay. See, this is the add unit code and this is the AdSense. Now in server side, I'm just gonna pass the in production, is production is equal to process.env dot node underscore env. It should be true false. Okay, equal to production. Okay, you may change that to triple equal to, but I don't care. I'm just gonna show you how the code is running. No, I'm just gonna show you the code. Now I got the Google Ad Unit component for me. So what, how can I use this? We are just gonna need the INS as a JSX format, INS in JSX format, and we need to wrap it under the Google Ad Unit. Just wait a minute. See, by done by this, you can use the Ad Unit code for your program or any website that uses Next.js 13 app route. Okay. Now it will refresh on every page change. If it helps,